Somehow, Mario had found the strength to cross the desert's sweltering dunes. Ahead was a sprawling complex of ruins rising out of the sand. Thankful for the shade, Mario and Tippy ventured deeper inside. They were the very ruins Old Man Watchet had warned them about. What dangers lurked in the shady corridors ahead? Hello everyone, my name is Luis, also known as LG65, and let's play Super Paper Mario Continues. Next chapter, Monster of the Ruins.
Mario, I can feel it calling. The pure heart is coming. But wait, I sense something else emanating from the sand dunes. Be careful now, Mario. Something else is waiting for us ahead.
Alright, so this is YoldRuins. Where are we at now? So, let's see how far deep we can get inside these ruins and figure out the mysteries. Let me go into 3D mode, see if there's any extra secrets. It doesn't look like there are any, but nice clipping, by the way. Okay. Alright, we first encounter with a buzzy beetle. Can we throw them? Very nice. I mean, can we even pick them up while, like, they're on their heads? And they're sunk. There's a mushroom. Ah! Yeah. And, of course, the fire bar. Everyone remembers the fire bar from the classic days of, Super Mario. There we go. That's beautiful. Alright, pick that up. See if I can use it for... see if I can make it useful. Oh goodness. Ah, I dropped it. Alright, get up there. See what else is hiding up. Perhaps a ladder? I wonder. What's hiding down here? Ooh! A life shroom. Automatically restores 5 HP. If you fall from grace. Or, lose all your HP and everything like that. I actually enjoy using the light shrooms on certain occasions, especially in Thousand Year Doors, where I always, fall to the last boss, which is the Shadow Queen. They've always came in handy, and I actually was had to use it once in the first game. Oh my goodness! Fire bars. Okay, that door's locked, so I can't do anything. So let's see what's hiding in 3D mode. What? Oh, this enemy. You're joking. Get out of here. Alright, let's switch back into 2D mode before anything else happens. Okay, I don't like the look of this. But at least we can, evade them. But if we wanted to, I could go into 3D mode to, easily avoid them. There's the ruins key. So I got them. So let's get out of here. Okay, now let's get a little bit closer. Ouch! Without getting hurt. Oh my goodness. Alright, let me save here. Nothing goes wrong, I should say. Alright, pick that up. And the toss fail. Obviously. Ooh. Yeah, can I get up there, please? Ah! But not get hit either. Okay, let's go into 3D mode for a second. What was up there anyway? That I can't, reach. Actually, I could go up there if I wanted to. Alright, get back. There we go. That was too close. Obviously, if I kept into 3D mode a little too long, then I would have suffered majorly. Ah, I took a hit. Because I wasn't fast enough in, you know. Alright, let's see. Okay, uncover the hidden block. But that hidden block is only accessible in 3D mode, I believe. Yes! Okay. It switches out of 3D mode whenever I near a door. Huh, that's clever. Okay, what's this now? Oh, right. It's like another one of those puzzle type things. Oh, it's so many struggles with this part. It's not even funny. So basically, I have to use the enemy as a, like one of those, as a prop to help, to like throw, to toss it at that switch. Obviously, throw was there. I got throw that, you know, really helped with this, but like, that was not fun, especially the first time around. So, you know, as I keep throwing, like I have throw-ins, yes, throw-ins. I have the Copa America on my brain, because I've been watching it as of late, and some very interesting storylines. With regards to the tournament, obviously Argentina being the top team, and they sort of took care of business in the first match day against, you know, Copa American champion Chile from 2015. My goodness, why can't I do this? Alright, let me knock it out and get another one. I think there's infinite amounts. Yes, there's infinite amounts. Okay, okay, obviously I can't go up the ladder. Perhaps I can leap up with it or something? There has to be. Oh, there we go!
Something happened outside the room!
Nice. Okay, so... And then I see Brazil are without Neymar. For... Because they're the parent... Because Barcelona were like, we don't want to send two, like, you know, Brazilian, you know, people to the Copa America. Okay, we're going to 3D mode to access this. If I can, but it doesn't seem like I'm able to. Oh, I have to use throw for this. There we go, that's better. And then, of course, like, I'm seeing, like, and then, of course, there's that stunner by host team, the United States, against, who was it? Costa Rica. Okay, this one's a hard one. Perhaps there's something hidden? Alright, let me go back up and investigate. Okay, I can't find anything. Maybe if I point the Wii remote? There's something there. I'll show it to you. There we go. Thank you, Tippy. And now, of course, I can't wait for tomorrow because the UEFA Euro European Championships begin. Oh, I'm in another room. Okay. Oh! Okay, this is gonna be trouble. Alright, so I have to somehow get my... Of course I'm in trouble. Ah, that's a nice illusion. That's a nice illusion. Alright. I'm gonna stay in 3D mode to stay out of trouble. Oh, what's this now? Ooh. How do I do this again? Quick menus, 1 and 2. Alright. Items. Give me... I'm not poisoned. Give me the cake mix. Some life will do. Oh, how about that? I managed to evade the, what's it called? The attack of the Buzzy Beetle. What's this now? Oh, it's a Buzzy Beetle card. Alright, it gives me, like, double damage on the Buzzy Beetles. Oh, these are nice collectibles. I should actually look for them. Oh my goodness, it's still bouncing around, that thing? Man, get it out of here. Okay, good. Now we're through. Spring. Okay, yeah. Okay, so far it looks like I'm only through on the left side and there's nothing here. Alright. Perhaps if I... Okay, I have to find a way across. Obviously. There's nothing in 3D mode, so I guess the only thing is the spring. Oh, that's... Okay. Okay, I have to find a way. And I can't pick it up, obviously. So, let me go into 3D mode to see what I'm able to find. What's this ladder doing there? Let me get up there. Get me up there! Okay, but I gotta hurry or else I will take damage. Done. Okay, take note that the ladder's back over to where I was at. Alright. Hit the switch. And there's another switch. At least, well, huh? Oh gosh! Okay, gotta run! Nice. Oh, some of those things actually fall. That's cool. Yeah, I don't want to be down there now. Alright, let's go back into 3D mode and just climb down, I guess. Okay. I don't know why, but this is just as bad. But they're not doing anything, so it doesn't really matter. Well, if I fell down, it would work either way. Okay, so... These switches... They mean something. I'm gonna try one. Looks like a code of sorts. Let me check. Oh, here we are. Oh, I see. Yeah, they're numbers. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Ah, and unlocked a thing of stairs. Nice. Very nice, I should say. Up. Actually, first though, in here's whoa! Max HP went up by 5. Nice. I'm gonna save here. Hopefully, there's nothing scary on the other side, but we'll see. Alright, looks like we're out. How about that? But, part of me doesn't feel comfortable. Then again, who knows, right? Warning! What? Intrusion detected. Leave immediately or be purged. Wait. Scan initialized. Red cap detected. Blue overalls detected. Level 5 mustache detected. Incredible. Possible subject identification. But it isn't possible. Hold your position. Searching databanks. Search complete. One positive match. System overload. Legendary hero identified. Forgive me, hero. I am called Fracktail. My only purpose is to defend a pure heart from lawless intruders. You are late. I have waited thousands of years for your arrival. You may pass. The pure heart is just ahead.
It won't be that easy. Oh no.
Who speaks? Dimitrio, how about that?
So very nice to meet you! And your mustache! I am Count Bleck's Master Dimensions! The please request! I am Dimitrio! Remember the name well!
You're not Rashid of Street Fighter V! What are you talking about?
I know you! You're that... It would be so very dull if your journey ended so easily. Instead, it ends with magic. Yes, much better. Now you and this robotic guardian can spend some quality time. Yes, quality snack time when he snacks on you, for you are the snack. Ciao. What did he just...
I am error. Press any key to restart. System not found. Insert install disk. Disk not found. Please confirm disk cover is closed. Read error. Insert boot disk. Press enter. No response. System may be busy. Remembering slash. Asterisk. Application error. Save your work and quit. You lost everything. Ready to go, genius. Ready for processes. 404. Computer hands not found. Threat level upgrades. Jelly roll run. Detonation imminent. See, run clear, end of game, see, run install generator, see the result, go away, Yeti lip, control, Autel. Oh my god. Okay, I think it's gonna run at me. Yep. This is Fracktail.
That's Fracktail, the robotic guardian of the pure heart. It is quite enormous. That makes me unknown. Attack is one. It can fly and swoop down with its open, big open mouth. But I think the antenna horn on top it says the sweet spot. I think you're gonna need to use the arrow to hit it.
Alright, well, right now it's out of range. So, gotta watch for Fracktail's approach. Oh, it's coming this way. It's coming this way. Ooh. Yeah. That's a massive wide area. I'm just running around mindlessly. Where's it going? Where's it going?
It's going to fly from the right. I can sense it. You should flip back in 3D.
Alright, go. Wow. Spot on. Thank you, Tippy. Alright, go! Okay, so once that thing comes, I should actually strike it with Thoro. So let's wait for the head to show. It's coming. Ah, I missed. Okay. Maybe in the 3D mode, perhaps? Okay. Alright. Now... let's see. 3D mode. Is it coming? Tippy, better let me know. Now! Yes! Okay. Ah, it didn't go! Okay. How am I supposed to hit it? Yeah, how am I supposed to hit it? Because all Thoro does is like throw straight right, straight left. And the antenna is obviously the weak point. But like, how can I like hit it proper? Especially with, you know, Fracktail on approach, like... okay, yeah, that doesn't help. Obviously his attack power is one from regardless of where Fracktail is positioned at. In other words, like, if he comes in from the, like, the front side, I'll get hit with only one hit point, regardless of what happens. And coming in from, like...
looks like Fracktail is charging straight at you. Better watch out!
Okay, yeah. Oh, again! Can't hit... you can't go on approach there. Alright. Better switch out! so... Alright, I gotta find something to strike Fracktail with. Anything. Anything at all. Because whatever I'm doing right now doesn't seem like it's working. Oh my god. Okay, this is ridiculous. I'm getting no hits whatsoever. Like, no hits on Fracktail. Okay, so it came straight. So, when I was in 3D mode, so I'm like... I've got to find a way to, you know, strike Fracktail. Maybe? That was the key? Yeah, maybe. Okay, now it's coming. Oh, there, that's how to do it. I just have to ride on its tail and, you know, hit the antenna with the minions. Okay, now it's gonna take me off. Okay, so that's how we do it. Okay, so when he approaches from the front, I can't really do much, but if he comes in from the charging position on the 3D end, then I start to ride on him. Ah, now I understand. Alright, here won't do it. Yeah, even if I try to, like, hop on, it won't work. So... okay, so... it's gonna come in from that side. Gonna wait on Fracktail to come and then hop on his tail. There we go. Now, a little rinse, rather, repeat while carrying one of these toys. You can reach the head in time, which I do. Sorry, Fracktail. I had to do this for your own good. Alright, he's gonna throw me off. Which is fine. I don't mind that. I can take as long as I need. By the way, I really enjoyed the dialogue there. Because, like, this reminded me from when I was using, like, MS-DOS from back in the day. Like, actually, back in the day. Because, like, we used to own one of those really, 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 really old computers that, like, run on MS-DOS, and I was playing a bunch of games on it. Like, let me see if I can recall some of them. Lemmings, Epic Pinball, what else? Hugo 3, Jungle Doom, I believe. And Midnight Rescue, Treasure Mountain. God, the memories, man. This is like... these memories. I think I and funnily enough, I'm recording this on a Thursday, so this is clearly Throwback Thursday. So hopefully this clip gets trending. System crash. I have malfunction. What have I done? Hero, the error is mine. I am sorry. Shame circuit smoldering. Please. We must save our world. But in the end, unlike any computer, we had to put it down. You
know? Welcome, hero. My name is Merlumina. I'm a dormant soul. I have waited long to give you the pure heart. Yes, I've been waiting for 1,500 years. Thank you. Your presence here must mean that all worlds have begun to collapse. Yes, they have, in fact. That's why we're here. Before I give you the pure heart, you and I must speak. Listen well, hero. Long, long ago, my people built a civilization hailed as a beacon of culture. Sadly, despite our power, there was one thing we were powerless to stop. The Dark Prognosticus. Nobody knows who authored that dark book. It foretold the events of the future. On the last page, it was written that a chaotic power would devour the world. We knew it had to be stopped. Our greatest minds devised a grand plan to stop the tragedy before it happened. We needed something with the pure essence of love to confront this chaos. Researchers set to work, and they created the Purity Heart. We divided the Purity Heart into 8 pieces and hid them in different dimensions. We hid them for their own protection, waiting for the day the hero would arrive. Everything was going as planned, or so it seemed. But the wheels of destiny began to spin wildly out of control. It began with a very small incident. At that time, I was young and quite beautiful. It started the day I met 2 very fetching young men. And you see, my life set sail towards a maelstrom of love. You see, I asked one out. But, however, it was, basically, it... And then I said... And he said... And then...
Oh boy, are we gonna get this Merlin moment again from Paper Mario 1? Yep, looks like it.
And that is why we hope the Purity Heart will have the power to defeat chaos. To save all worlds, we must find the 8 pure hearts that form the Purity Heart. And that is all I have to say on the matter. Were you listening carefully?
Yeah.
Excellent. I did tell the short version, so I wasn't sure if you would fully understand. It is up to you to find the pure hearts, for they are our last and only hope. Go forth, hero, and save the world. We are all depending on you.
You've got a pure heart. End of chapter. Before disappearing, Verlumina had entrusted Mario to save every world. She had waited 1,500 years to deliver the message to the legendary hero. With the second pure heart in hand, Mario was in great spirits. But 6 pure hearts still remained to be found, and the journey had just begun. With a flutter, Tippy said, "I think we'd better return to Flipside." The weight of every world's fate once again rested on Mario's shoulders.
Yeah, so I guess the hero went ahead and stopped you and sent you back here?
You gotta forgive me, Count. I failed you. I never felt less chunky in my life.
So our hero is real. Yes, a force to be reckoned with. Nastas, the prophecy. Consult it and learn where the hero will go next. We will lay a devious trap for him and bring him to his very knees. Black.
Yeah, I already sent Mimi to a site picked for that purpose.
This pleases Count Black. Excellent work, Nastasia. I have granted Mimi powers potent enough to ensure that she will obliterate this hero. Yes, he will be helpless against her. I depart. Alert Count Black when this hero is no more. Black.
Yeah, I'll fire off a memo on that. But for now, we have another item on the agenda. Oh, Chunks, you got a sec? Yeah, so some minions in the Bowser organization are still resisting assimilation. So I'm heading out to squash the resistance. And while I'm gone, I want you to stay here. Yeah, you just sit tight and think about your recent job performance, okay?
Oh, this really tweaks me chin-hairs.
What? How did I end up napping here? Wait. Didn't that nasty Count Bleck try to make me marry Bowser? And then Luigi here. Luigi? Bowser? Anybody there?
No, you're the only one of the wedding party left standing, it looks like. So you finally woke up, huh, Princess?
Oh, you guys! Are you alright?
Yeah, but who knows what happened? That was one crazy wedding! He can't even find his groomness! You remember, King Bowser? Oh, and that guy with the mustache. I think he had on a green tuxer on or something? Yeah, Luigi. That's the guy. We don't know where he ended up either. Thing is, most of us minions got all brainwashed by that black guy's assistant. Yeah, everybody's half nuts. It's not safe here. We gotta clear this area now! Private Koopa here will escort you, alright? You guys make a break for it.
But what about you?
What am I gonna do? I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go help my men. King Bowser would burn me to a crisp if I left them. Leave no Koopa behind. Good luck out there, Princess. Hail Bowser!
Farewell.
Okay, lady, we gotta evac this zone. Let's roll. And Peach is... Yeah. We can step into her shoes as a regulator.
You, give up! There's no hope of escape.
Oh, these guys. All hail the glorious Count. Do not resist. Submit to his rule. You will love it. What's this insubordination? Johnson, I am your captain. Drop and give me 20.
Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna have to tell you that your orders mean nothing. See, they've already sworn eternal allegiance to Count Fleck, okay? And now you need to, so I'll just go ahead and pin you in for 10 o'clock brainwashing.
You just messed with the wrong Koopa! I Sir Bowser! You tell this count of yours! Hail Black!
Yeah, there. Isn't that better? So listen, there's still a few problem minions that haven't sworn allegiance. You be a lamb and round them up for me, okay?
Thanks. Yes, ma'am. Oh man, this is going downhill fast! I mean, did you see that? They even broke the captain! Look, lady, they find us, it is game over, so we gotta clear this area. STAT! Okay, so basically, we gotta leave, you know, the castle, so hopefully, don't get spotted by anyone whatsoever. Hopefully I can stay low. And it looks like I'm doing a decent job so far, so... Yeah. Is this the exit? Maybe? probably is.
No! No! Dead end!
Well, staying here won't do us any good. Let's turn around and keep looking.
Oh, turn back?
Yeah, no. Your friend there had it right. This is your dead end. Who are you anyway?
Find cover, lady. I'm trained to handle scum like this. Oh, hell, Count Black.
Wow, Princess, you sure are lucky. I thought the wedding explosion finished you. Yeah, but this is the end of the road, and your luck runs out right here. It's time you came on over and got with the program. Come and serve the Count. Never! Yeah, that's great and all, but my hypno powers kinda say otherwise. Just sit tight a second, okay? Cause I've got just to brainwash you real quick. What? That wasn't on my schedule! Where'd she go? Well, that's really not a deal breaker. Our prophecy fulfillment plan is running smoother. We have no need for her. Yeah, and it doesn't matter where she runs, since all worlds are about to fall.
I remember that day well. The room was warm. The whole place was at peace. You're awake at last? What? Where am I? Is this a human's home? Leck, don't wiggle like that. I found you at the cliff base. You took quite a fall. You're human, right? I don't repulse you. I am a detritus of darkness. Why would that matter? Anyone with a heart would not ignore an injured soul. That was the day our paths crossed. That day, that was the day our tragedy was set into motion. If you get a pure heart, you can choose to visit specific sections in each chapter.
First to Merlin's place.
Alright, let's get on that actually. Because I kinda wanna go there. Wait. The elevator's on that side to the left. Yeah, I keep forgetting that.
Huh.
Hey, I can be forgetful sometimes, because keep in mind I haven't played in this game in a while. Because I had things to do. For instance, my trip to the States, down to New Orleans, Louisiana, and Houston, Texas. And then of course I had my Steins Gate Let's Play to do.
We returned so soon? I can see from your faces that it went well, indeed. Let's head back to my house so you can tell the details. Please step right in.
Alright, let's do that.
So how was it, dear friends? Did you find a pure heart? Oh, such a pure brilliance. This is a true piece of the one true purity heart.
Yes, we met Merlumina, and she gave it to us.
What? Meet Lady Merlumina?
We were well met. She's an ancestor of mine. She was the one who wrote the Light Prognosticus to counteract the Dark One.
Merlumina and those who followed her built this town. They are why we are here.
Master Merlin! Bad news!
What is it? Get a hold of yourself, lad!
You see, you see, a girl fell out of the sky!
What? A girl fell out of the sky? What in the world?
I don't know. Just please, get on the elevator and come up there and see her.
So it shall be. And you, Mark, come along. We may need your presence as well.
I love it. He's like, me? Yes, yeah, let's get on that. Right now. Come on, don't slow me down now. I think they went up to this elevator. Yeah, looks like it. Third floor. Okay, not this way. Perhaps it's to the left? Yeah, so I was looking up at the tower and she fell out of nowhere.
She does not look at all familiar to me. Who could this be?
What's the matter?
Oh.
Princess Peach? So this is the princess that Count Black kidnapped.
Yes.
Well, the poor girl seems to have a rough time. Of that we can be sure. She doesn't appear to be conscious. She is shivering uncontrollably. What could the problem be? Oh, I know. Mario, you must go to the chef named Saffron on the first floor flip side. I am sure she knows a warming revitalizing recipe for this pure girl, poor girl. Once she revives, we will be able to ask Princess Peach exactly what happened. Now off with you. Find Saffron, the chef, on the first floor.
Well then, we gotta get on that now. Okay, this could take a while, but you know what though? I have plenty of time, so... Let me see what else is on my mind. Apart from the Euros, and of course the, and the Copa America. Okay, this is the way to the first floor. This was the second floor, yeah? Let me see what happens if I take this elevator. I think I missed paying attention to the floor numbers. So, Oh, this is the first floor. Okay, gotta find Saffron. Okay, yeah. So I think this must be it. Oh. No, not quite. It's just random citizen. Yeah, I didn't... I gotta be careful about my vocal levels. Oh, here we go. This is it.
Welcome to Sweet Smiles. Ooh, sugar. Our dish is to turn that little frown upside down. What? A free use is out cold. Oh, mercy. Well, listen here, sugar. She sounds like she needs some spice soup. All it needs is a fire burst to make a pot of soup that'll warm her up in the jiffy. Some store sell for spice burst, so just check the sales wherever you like to shop. You bring me one, sugar, and I'll make you some tasty, spicy soup. But, ooh, my, it looks like you already have a fire burst now, don't you? Aren't you the enterprising one? Hand it over and I'll whip up some spice soup.
Yes, let's give her that. I never used it, thank God.
So, sugar, you want me to turn a crazy dish for you with some fire burst?
Yes.
What's by Suzu? Come right up, sugar! Ooh la la, yum! Put it in your tongue! Sorry about the wait, sugar, but it turned out just right!
There you go.
This is how to wake up that sleeping beauty of yours, sugar. Get it to her just as quick as you can!
Alright, good. I'm actually very thankful I've not used a fire burst, because that would have been a really long trip to whatever store like I can get them from. Like, I can get stuff from any store, really. I think I came across one while we were in Yold Town or something, or that Yold Outpost, or something along those lines. So that was pretty crazy just to even think about for a second. Anyways, so we got it. Now we have the spicy soup. So let's hand it to Peach. Here you go.
Oh, it seems to have worked.
I feel like I just ate the most delicious thing. I haven't had a dream about
such tasty food in ages. Oh, Mario! You're okay! Mm-hmm. Where exactly are we? This is Flipside. Okay, and who are you?
My dear, I am called Merlon, and that is what's known as a pixel. Her name is Tippy. Come, let us adjourn to my house. I would be grateful if you would tell us more there.
Yeah.
And then before I knew it, I awoke and saw Mario, you, and Tippy.
Well, my dear, that is the most assuredly a tale of woe and troubles.
Oh, Mario, what do you suppose happened to Luigi and Bowser? I suppose you're right. There's just no way to know. I just hope they're safe. Merlin, what should we do next?
And one pure heart shall lead the way to the next. So it is written. There are still more heart pillars to be found in Flipside, young ones. When you find the next heart pillar, you must set a pure heart in it. And when you do so, a door to the world containing the next pure heart will appear. And my intuition tells me that the next door may lead you to the mysterious Merli. Like Bestovius and I, Merli is one of the ancients. We are like long-lost cousins. Yes, I've heard that Merli has long guarded an ancient and secret treasure. If my instincts are correct, it may be the next pure heart we seek. I must tell you, the light prognosticus also speaks of her magic powers.
We just need to find this Merli person. Is that it?
Oh-ho! Are you going as well? You should not tax yourself. You've only just recovered. And it may be dangerous.
Well, I can't just sit here and let everyone else go off to save the world now, can I? After all, the void is spreading in the sky. That is my fault. Mine and Bowser's. So I'm going, and that's final! I made my decision!
Peach has joined your party. Now you can control not just Mario, but Princess Peach as well.
I guess we need to find that next heart pillar.
This princess is headstrong to be sure. How very refreshing. I insist you take this.
Key to a door somewhere in town.
There are secrets in this town that even I do not know. This may be one of the keys to uncovering them. Quite literally, in fact. Please use these keys to whatever it fits here in town. My intuition tells me you should be able to use it very near my house. I will continue to read the light prognosticus and look for any clues that may help. I am sure that musty old tome still has much to teach us. Yes, much indeed. Now, Mario, Princess Peach, do all you can to stop the Count's evil plans.
Let's go, Mario. Come on, Tibby.
Yeah.
When playing as Princess Peach, you can use her umbrella in a few ways. Press and hold the 2 button while jumping to float slowly down. In addition, press the D-pad down to use your umbrella to guard against enemy attacks. When you want to change a character, choose him or her on the menu screen. Okay, next to the house, I suppose. Hey, that key, right? And obviously, I can't go into 3D mode in this style. So, yeah. Okay, obviously, this is the shop. Yeah. Actually, you know what though? I'm actually going to slap the pure heart we just picked up into that pillar. And then I'm going to end the video off. Quite long, but you know what though? It's been fun. So, like, I'm actually glad that I finally got to this point. So now I kind of figured out what to do. And also, like, I have a greater understanding in, things. Okay. Let me actually switch to Mario. Okay, it's not this floor. It was in that other floor that I just saw a little while ago. Oh boy, I can be forgetful. But you know what though? Like, it's the nature of blind LPs like this one. So like, there's gonna be some things where I wish I knew what to do, but, or like, I know exactly what to do, but totally am forgetful about it. But at the same time though, it's like, oh, I should be able to handle this just fine. So here we are again. Now we can enter Lineland from here, but we're actually gonna see about, okay, can we, like, you know, put this in one of the pillars now? Cause right now I kinda am stuck on how to do this. And obviously it's like one of those, you know, that's four nines. Okay, I guess we have to do something with respect to the key. I thought it would be a little bit simple, but no, I think there's a little more next to it. Okay, so according to Merlin, we've been given an old key that, you know, fits somewhere next to his home or something along those lines. So let me just see if I'm able to access that. Like, honestly, it's gotta be somewhere. I of course just have to find it. Perhaps it's this one? No, probably not here. Now, it could take me a while, so we're out of order, I know that. The key word is right next to Merlin's home. So I have to think about it for a minute. And obviously it cannot go to 3D mode here. Slightly bigger mess than it should be. Okay. Nothing. Okay, keywords there. Close next to his home. Somewheres. Now, my only question is, where? Because that's the problem I'm facing right about now. And it only looked to me, like there was something more than just, I thought I couldn't. Okay, let's use that old key. Okay, on the other side, looks like I have to go into 3D mode and investigate this section. Okay, that reads, flip side outskirts ahead. Monster advisory. Oh dear. I love this. Is this the secret that I was supposed to know about? Or is this something brand new? Nope. Here we go. Okay, first floor. Outskirts. What's this? Hey hero, feeling stumped? Try flipping. It's pretty basic. Oh my god. Okay, okay, yeah. check in on that. Okay, I gotta hurry here. Otherwise, I lose HP automatically. There we go. Oh, now, what's this? Obviously, I can reach up there. Yep. Heart pillar ahead. The best route, you ask? Float across the stone tops. Okay, I'm gonna switch over to Peach. Oh, I missed! There we go. Oh my gosh. Oh, I couldn't even reach that! Alright, let me carry that. Can I flip at any time? Oh wait, that's Mario's thing. Right. How the heck? How in the heck? Okay. That's beyond weird. Okay. Now. Okay, so basically, that thing gave me a hint. That sign gave me a hint. So I have to go with Peach. So obviously I can't go into 3D mode as Peach, but I can still float. Like so. There you go. And now! Isn't that beautiful? Sorry, I didn't mean to do that, but I just am a little bit shocked and all, but at the same time though, it's like pretty impressive. Okay, so having these extra abilities makes playing this game very, very interesting. And you have to switch in and out between multiple party members. So, it's actually quite very useful in this sense. Let's see what else is around here. And especially in 3D mode. Okay, nothing. Alright. Gotta, like, alright, gonna quickly rush back to the inner edge. Oh, I forgot to save, didn't I? That's okay. I'm actually going to, you know, stand in front of the door of the next area, and then to that end, I'm going to end the video. Wow, that was a lot of fun. I can't wait to see what the next area brings. So, next time in Let's Play Super Paper Mario, we begin our journey to find the next pure heart. So take care, everyone. And remember, life's good.